Welcome to the Nevis Newscast for Tuesday, March 9th, 2021. I am Bronte Swanston Hendrickson. Theresa Terry Andrews, Lydia Thompson Claxton, Governor Manners Hendrickson, Maritza Williams, and Wanda Parry were awarded by the Department of Sports in a ceremony held on Monday, March 8th at the Jessup's Community Center. The ceremony took place in honor of International Women's Day, which was also celebrated on March 8th. Minister of Sports in the Nevis Island Administration, the Honorable Eric Evelyn, was present and delivered brief remarks.
The moment I looked at the names, I said they're all very deserving persons. Because I could tell you, and I believe that is the consensus of all of us who are here, and all of us in Nevis, that all of you are stars in your own right. You are stars in your own right, and you have been committed to what you do. Of course, we know what Maritza's exploits are. She was an Olympian. And it's not very often that you get someone from a small island like Nevis reaching that stage. Mrs. Parry is someone who has been so committed to the sports of basketball. When she was the president, she almost single-handedly ran that association. And I was always amazed how she always got things done and always got them done so well. She was at the helm of that association for many years and she did a marvelous job. Mrs. Manners Hendrickson, she's half from Gingerland. She grew up in Charlestown, but because of her husband, she's now back in Gingerland and making a sterling contribution to the Dynamics Social Sports Club, the Dynamics Sports Club. And Govani is always busy in all sports. Netball, basketball, cricket, what have you. Lydia, of course, would have put us on the map by making the West Indies team in netball. And she's still very, very vibrant. I don't know how many of us saw her on the court at Brown Hill a couple of months ago. And when I looked at Lydia, I said, this can't be the same Lydia. The way how she was moving, so very agile. And she still has a lot to offer in netball. So we know what Terry has done for Special Olympics in St. Kitts and Nevis. I would not say Nevis alone, I would say St. Kitts and Nevis. Because they would have gone to Abu Dhabi 2 years ago, was it Terry? And made a mark. Made a mark. And it hasn't stopped there, because she continues to work hard with the Special Olympians, and now she's also making a name with the Swim to Win initiative.
Minister Evelyn and his Assistant Permanent Secretary, D. Michelle Liebert, presented the awards to the honorees. Theresa Terry Andrews received the award in a Special Olympics. Lydia Thompson Claxton in the area of netball, Governor Manners Hendrickson in the area of community sports, Maritza Williams for track and field, and Wanda Parry for basketball administration. The feature address was delivered by sports officers Sienna Liebert and Carisha Powell. The chairperson of the evening's event was Tricia Daniel.
I feel it important for me to also point out that women, just as in the case of men, women should seek to be leaders for the right reason, to serve others, not for fame or power or self-aggrandizement, but to be in service to others. This is the only way we will be able to impact lives for the better and help our nation communities and families. I wish to say to each woman and girl that there is not only a leader in you, but there is a leader in you that the world is waiting on. However, the only way for you to grow into a leader that positively impacts the world and unlock the hidden leaders in others is to begin cultivating leadership qualities such as honesty, selflessness, dependability, and respect.
Junior Minister of Gender Affairs, the Honourable Hazel Brandy Williams, speaking in an official address to mark the celebration of International Women's Day on March 8, 2021. The Gender Affairs Minister noted that these qualities are the same that propelled to prominence the outstanding regional leaders such as Dame Mary Eugenia Charles, female Prime Minister of Dominica, in St. Kitts and Nevis, Dame Constance Mitchell, first female Member of Parliament, and Member of Parliament Jacynth Henry-Martin. She noted, however, that leadership is not to be thought of merely as political.
Leadership need not be thought of as merely political. The contributions of women in every sphere of our nation's life is crucial for our collective success. Many of us have witnessed other outstanding women community leaders, such as Mrs. Alvis Dyer, female generals of faith, such as the Reverend Eunice Griffin, outstanding farmers, such as Emmontine Liburd, and sporting champions, such as Janet Grell Hull. The International Women's Day, we honor and salute them and the thousands of women who lead us at home, at school, at the market, in businesses, or even on the street corner, into greater heights of success and well-being.
Junior Minister of Gender Affairs, the Honourable Hazel Brandy Williams. As part of the activities for the celebration of International Women's Month, the Assistant Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Health and Gender Affairs, Latoya Jeffers, is encouraging persons to apply for the Earth University Scholarships.
We are also having an advert for women to apply for the Earth University Scholarship. This scholarship is being offered because of Women's Month, and we want as many persons as possible to fill the application. The deadline was originally February 28th, but it has been extended to March 15th, so there is still time for you to apply. So please take advantage of this opportunity. If you have any questions, please call the Gender Affairs Department at 469-5521 extension 6750.
The deadline for the scholarship application was extended to Monday, March 15, 2021. The following is a press release from the Nevis Tourism Authority, NTA, dated March 6, 2021, regarding a Variety magazine feature on Nevis. Variety magazine, the industry leader and standard bearer for all things related to entertainment, has featured Nevis's groundbreaking agreement with MSR Media to shoot 6 films on the island, the first and most significant step in developing a world-class film industry on this lovely Caribbean island. Senior Variety editor Anna Marie De La Fuente interviewed Nevis Tourism Authority NTA Chief Executive Officer Jadine Yard and MSR Media producer Philippe Martinez for the in-depth story and quoted from statement issued by the Honorable Premier Mark Brantley on the government's desire to partner with filmmakers to develop a film industry on Nevis. The article noted that due to the stringent health and safety protocols developed and implemented by the government of the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis to protect both visitors and citizens, there have been very few COVID-19 cases and no deaths, making Nevis one of the safest places in the world. Producer Philippe Martinez acknowledged that Nevis ticked all the boxes for health and safety protocols that would make the film production possible. The Nevis Tourism Authority assisted in facilitating the movement of the production crews to the island, including negotiating preferential hotel rates and access to multiple locations across the island. Filming of the romantic comedy titled One Year Off, directed by Brad Weston and co-written by Kate Wood, Martinez and Stuart Thompson, has already started on island. According to the NTA's Chief Executive Officer, Jadine Yard, the production will generate at least 150 jobs and inject US $1 million into the economy. More importantly, it will increase everyone's morale as tourism has been halved due to the pandemic. Additionally, MSR Media has announced the creation of an education program to train local people in a variety of on-set roles in an effort to boost the island's production infrastructure. They will be hiring at least 30 local actors who will be given acting classes by a Shakespearean actor who has been living in Nevis for the past 20 years. And that's it for this edition of the Nevis Newscast. On behalf of all of us here at the Department of Information, I am Bronte Swanston Hendrickson. Thank you for viewing.